In this lecture, we shall see the distribution of pressure in longitudinal waves. We know that sound waves are longitudinal waves which propagate through a gaseous medium. And in the propagation, the longitudinal waves are accompanied by compressions and rarefactions. Where the pressure is more, these are the compressions, and where the pressure is less, these are the rarefactions. We assume here a longitudinal wave which is advancing through a medium having air from left to right. And here we have considered air layer, this AB, perpendicular to the direction of propagation, which is at a distance x from arbitrary point O. So we have air layer AB at a distance x from arbitrary point O. We consider another air layer CD which is at a distance x plus dx from O. Now, the volume enclosed between these two layers can be found out like this. Let us suppose the area of both the layers be alpha. Area of the layer AB or CD be alpha. Now the distance between these two layers is equal to BD, as you can see in this figure. And how to find out this BD? The distance of the layer CD from O is x plus dx. X plus ds, as you can see here, and the distance of the layer AB from O is x. So obviously BD will be OD minus OB, that is x plus dx minus x. Therefore the volume enclosed between the layers AB and CD is given by the area and the distance between the layers AB and CD, that is x plus dx minus x, and this is equal to alpha dx. Now as the wave is progressing towards right, the layer AB gets displaced to A dash B dash, and the layer CD gets displaced to C dash D dash. AB moves to A dash B dash, which is at distance y from AB, and the layer C dash D dash moves to CD moves to C dash D dash, which is at distance y plus dy from this CD. As the layer moves to different points, there will be change in volume of the layer between these A-dash, B-dash and C-dash, D-dash, and hence there will be a change of pressure at different points. Now let us find out this volume between the layer A-dash, B-dash and C-dash, D-dash. So AB moves to A-dash, B-dash at distance y from AB and C dash D dash moves to CD moves to C dash D dash at distance y plus dy from CD. Therefore, the volume enclosed between the layers A dash B dash and C dash D dash is given by alpha, and how much is the distance between A dash B dash and C dash D dash? It is B dash and D dash. So we can find out B dash and D dash, the value B dash D dash, by subtracting the value of O B dash and this O D dash and O B dash, that is O D dash minus O B dash. This is how much O D dash is equal to X plus DX plus Y plus DY. So let us write it, X plus DX plus Y plus DY minus this value O B dash, and this is how much, X plus Y, this plus this, this is X plus Y. So what we get, this is equal to alpha and X plus Y gets cancelled out, so we get DX plus DY. Therefore, the volume enclosed between A dash B dash and C dash D dash is alpha DX plus DY. Now, therefore, the change in volume is how much? This is equal to alpha dx plus dy minus alpha dx, and this is equal to alpha dx minus alpha dy minus alpha dx, and this is equal to alpha, so this is plus alpha dy. Now, what is strain? This is the volumetric strain or the volume strain is equal to the change in volume by the original volume. So this is equal to alpha dy by alpha dx, and this is equal to dy by dx. So volume strain is dy by dx. And then the bulk modulus, let us let this be K, and this is equal to the volume stress by the volume strain. So let the volume stress be minus dp, and volume strain is, we have already found out, is dy by dx. Here we have taken negative sign because the change or the increase in volume is associated with a decrease in pressure and vice versa. Or from here, dp equal to minus k dy by dx. Now we know the well-known wave equation is given by y equal to a sine 2 pi by lambda vt minus x, or dy by dx is equal to minus a 2 pi by lambda cos 2 pi by lambda vt minus x. Or putting the value of dy by dx in the equation, this equation, we have dp equal to minus k minus a 2 pi by lambda cos 2 pi by lambda vt minus x. And this is equal to k 2 pi by lambda a cos 2 pi by lambda vt minus x, or dp equal to k 2 pi by lambda a cos 2 pi by lambda vt minus x. Let us name this equation as equation number 1, that is a displacement equation or the displacement wave equation, and let us name this as equation number 2. Now we can write equation number 2 like this also, dp equal to k 2 pi by lambda a sine 2 pi by lambda vt minus x plus pi by 2. And this is, suppose, equation number 3. Now from equation number 2 we can see that dp is also varying with time t and distance x. And also comparing equation 1 and equation 3, we find that this dp is ahead of y by a phase factor pi by 2. When y equal to 0, vt minus x is 0, and therefore dp at vt minus x 0 is equal to k 2 pi by lambda a, and this is the maximum value or amplitude of dp. Now we can see how the pressure wave is ahead of this displacement wave y. Let us draw it. This is displacement. This is time. Let this be T by 4. This is T by 2. This is 3T by 4. And this is T. This is the change in pressure, dP. This is T. And the corresponding points can be drawn like this. This is T by 4, this is T by 2, this is 3T by 4, and this is T. Now the variation of the displacement wave is like this. Starts from here, attains the maximum value, goes like this. This is the maximum value in the negative side, and like this, and so on. Now this is the value at y equal to 0, and at y equal to 0 the value of change in pressure dP is maximum. So it will start from here like this, it is like this. This is the maximum value of the change in pressure at y equal to 0. And this value is 2 pi by lambda k A. And this is the least value of pressure. So these points having the maximum value of pressure called compression. These are compression. And this point of least value of pressure is called rarefaction. So we can see that the pressure wave is always ahead of the displacement wave by the phase factor pi by 2. At y equal to 0, dP equal to 2 pi by lambda Ka, giving the maximum value of the change in pressure dP. Thus, the phase angle pi by 2 always exists between the pressure amplitude and the displacement amplitude. So this is all about the distribution of pressure in a longitudinal wave.